Hi, my name is Ben Sondgeroth, and I'm an instructor with Edtech Teacher. Prior to joining Edtech Teacher last June, in June of 2016, I was a high school history teacher for 4 years, and then a director of technology for 2 years, where I led our school district in going one-to-one with Google Chromebooks. I've been using Kami for probably the last two years, I think, and found out about it through a colleague who absolutely loved the ability to annotate on PDFs and show teachers the power of annotating on PDFs. And after she showed me what it was and what it was all about, I fell in love, and I've been using it and showing teachers ever since. Teachers love being able to annotate directly on their PDFs that they share out with their students, whether that's putting text on them or using the writing tool to mark up and annotate directly on it. I think those are the two really big features that teachers love to bring in. PDFs that they've used successfully in the past, but then digitize those activities so they're not losing work that they've already done and created, and being able to rebrand and rebuild and really make the PDFs interactive. I also like when they can comment on them and add comments and share them out and really make a collaborative experience for the students. So I think tying it all together, your teachers are like, everybody produces content in PDF ways. And so teachers are overwhelmed and flooded with PDFs a lot. And when that happens, they don't know how they can distribute these things effectively out to their students, because a lot of the stuff is really good, but they don't want to just print out thousands of pages of paper to use with their kids every day. And so Kami ties that in by allowing these teachers to bring in the stuff that's pre-created, but then put their own individual spin on it. So it doesn't have to be just the standard stick, block, whatever boxes that they're using where they're just putting text in. Now they can bring in all these other resources and allow kids to really flourish creatively with using Kami instead of just writing on them as a worksheet. The post that I wrote about using Kami in the social studies classroom, I had a lot of really fun activities that I think social studies teachers can use. Some of the tools inside of Kami really lend themselves to like close reading, and so it's easy to share out a primary source in a PDF format with your students, have them open it up in Kami, and then they can use the highlighting tool, the underlining tool, the strike-through tool to go through and really find different pieces of, say, a primary source text and analyze it effectively. So the teacher can ask them to find certain aspects of the text. They can go through, use the annotation tools to go in and actually mark up the PDF that shows the teacher that they're understanding the content of the text. And it's not just a simple three questions at the end of the passage and asking them to read. Another piece that I really thought would be cool is if you bring in an image. So a teacher can share an image with the parent or with the students through PDF. They can use the line feature to kind of quadrant out the image. And then they can use the drawing tools to kind of mark up and really locate different pieces and really closely analyze a primary source image, which is important in a social studies classroom. I think a really effective way to do that would be political cartoons, for example. Political cartoons are just layered with content and information that students really have to dig into and analyze and find all the little bits and pieces. The annotative capacity of Kami allows them to do that. So they can go in, they can circle different little minor aspects of the political cartoon that might transform learning in that classroom. They can also take maps, you know, something as simple as a PDF map, and now they can transform that map into a way that is interactive, that is engaging, that they're not just saying, oh, this is where they went. They can put text on, they can draw the routes, they can circle, they can highlight, and they can really make that map come to life as opposed to just answering a couple of questions on it. So I think those are three ways that I would really encourage social studies teachers to use Kami in their classrooms. So what I really like about Kami is, you know, that you have all sorts of different features and functions. Honestly, I haven't used a lot of other products because I haven't needed it, because you guys provide that for me. I like the ability that it integrates directly into Google Drive, that it integrates directly into my Google app. So as soon as I open up a PDF, I get the option to open it up in Kami. It pops it up. You know, it's so well integrated that's where I kind of go with it right away, is that it's just easy to use. It's user friendly. It gives you a great toolbar. You can change your sizes, your fonts. You can do everything you want just directly in that toolbar, and you don't have to go anywhere else. You don't have to open up the file in a separate program. You don't have to worry about it not converting correctly because it's not going to open up right. So it's just a lot of fun. It's real easy to use, and that's where I think it wins with me. Awesome. I'm a believer in it. I teach it all the time. My teachers that I use it with love it, and we're just looking forward to seeing where the future lies with it and how much it can grow.